Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to introduce our first guest for the evening. This young lady actually has an incredible youth mentoring program, the new Flex. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. Warm round of applause, recognized round of applause for Miss Nesta
Felix, a.k.a. Coach Felix.
What up, Coach?
Oh, handsome, handsome guys here. Okay, now. Woo. Hey, hey, I can't get any dance move from y'all? Come on, y'all can dance better than me. No?
They gonna let me win the dance challenge.
No, please don't let them win, please. All right, so today we here to talk about sports, baby. All right, so tell us about the program.
So we are a mentoring, leadership, and sports program. In our office is in Westchester, Mount Vernon, but we have programs throughout the Bronx also. And we've been in existence since 2008.
Yes.
We were featured on Good Morning America about 2 years ago with Tim Tebow, and they did wonderful things with our program. So our boys are here today, even though we have hundreds of girls also.
Yeah.
And they just were the lucky few that hung out with Coach Felix.
Well, hold on. Can we get a round of applause for that? Because they definitely was out here working right now. And with the New Flex Youth, right, program, what made you want to call it the New Flex? Because I'm feeling that.
Well, it's interesting. It was by default. Mm-hmm. I coach college ball, so I'm actually, my niche is in sports with men and women. I train all over New York.
Okay.
And so years ago, New Flex was actually my thesis in my master's program. And I never actually imagined that it would evolve into this kind of program. My name is Nesta Felix, so people tend to think that it's my initials, but it's not. My former partner, her last name was Newson, and mine was Felix. And so New Flex became. And so when she and I parted ways, it just kind of lasted that it would be New Flex. So it was just by default, and here we are.
Yes. Do you guys travel from state to state, or?
Well, we are. We expose the youth to a lot of things. So mentoring is our number one focus. So programs like this are wonderful.
Okay.
Because one of our friends actually invited us here, one of the mentors. And so our boys, we like to expose our boys and our girls to these programs. So we're actually going camping a few times this summer. We are going to be in Delaware. We're going to be in Albany. We're going to be in various other places. And it's just, again, basketball is just the smallest part of what we do, but it is a caveat in which we set up programs.
And where the ages range from?
So our youngest is about 5 and our oldest is about 16. And I'll take it.
Hey now.
And this is the year that a lot of our children are turning over who started very young at this age. We have one of our boys who just signed with LSU actually about last season. He redshirted. We have two of our other up-and-coming students that are signing with colleges. One of our girls just signed with Pace on a full scholarship. So a lot of them are just doing things with us year-round. And they have the experience of a coach. I actually played Division I basketball.
Mm-hmm.
So I get to expose them to. And again, not all my children play, but they're a part of that team atmosphere that sports brings into.
We actually happen to have a hoop that we're going to be bringing.
Well, I mean,
out.
I can take.
Here we go.
I'm not afraid. I am very willing. I still got the jump shot, the crossover, and
okay.
all.
Ooh, okay.
Will you hear that? Okay. For my do it for the ladies.
And it's nice. All their games came from a lady. So I coach them. They are in program. They're developing and they're good.
Okay.
Nice. And they're in basketball, but I do not accept them on the court without things happening off the court, so they understand the dynamic.
And education and so on and so
absolutely.
Forth.
Absolutely.
And schoolwork is number one. That comes first. Do you be checking grades?
Oh, yeah. So we have to bring report cards. And actually, we were taking a little tour through the theater, and one of my boys, Quincy, you can put your hands up. So we were beating up about the founder, and so he just like cut in front of me because he wanted to read it, and he was just showing off, and he was just reading and killing it. And one of the sentences on there were talking about the deprivation of culture.
Yes.
So I said, Q, what's deprivation? And he was like, so I just broke the word down for him. And so those are opportunities. That's why our theme is hoops without mentoring is hopeless.
Right.
If you have the children in any kind of arts program or anything, and you're not engaging their intellect and other parts of them, then you're failing them. And so we have large responsibilities, and we have opportunities.
Oh,
do good by them.
You know what? Really quick, shout out to the National Black Theater.
Definitely allowing us to come down.
He is there. And I'm first of all, once again, salute to all of you guys, but salute to you young men for wanting to read and learn more about what's going on.
Yeah.
I am an advocate of, you know, every month is Black History Month.
Yes.
You can't give us just one month. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're just too incredible. You know what I'm saying? For one month. So every month is Black History Month. Keep on teaching.
When it comes to being a mentor, how can someone like me sign up?
Thank you. I was waiting for that question.
Come on now. Hey, right?
That's my number one question. I had it planned. Nothing else mattered for that question today. So literally while you guys were setting up, we were talking about the process of setting up. And so I said to them, the reason why they're taking time is because the prep takes more time than the actual show. And we were going in. And I said, so just to say to you that the plethora of people in the audience, everyone has something to give back. So I appreciate you guys. Newflex.org is the website. Whatever you have to give back, if you sew, if you dance, if you do film, we can make the time and we fit it in with our program. So if you say, I want to come up on this day, we will make them available in any of our programs.
And also with the mentoring, obviously, is with schoolwork. So they also sit down at a desk together.
Definitely.
Do the students, like, mentor each other or do, like, older?
Yes, we do. So whenever there's opportunity, like one of our sites, we went in and I saw that they were third grade boys. They were struggling with reading. Mm-hmm. And so they didn't know it. But next week, they're going to be starting with our younger children at the site where they play. And so what I do is say sports is a caveat because often with children, you have a difficult time getting them where you need them to be.
Yes.
But today, because they knew pizza was coming this evening, so I had children lined up. The building didn't even open yet. I had my boys lined up, dribbling the ball. I'm like, yeah, I bet. So what we do is we give them what they want, and then we have them give them what they need. And so that's what we need. We need community. And so I will have them there. If you know, if it's during a practice time, usually at the end or at the beginning, they will share and exchange the mentoring. So you're always, always accessible. Our calendar is public knowledge, public information. From January 1st to December 30th, we have things going on. So we need you.
All around, and other than basketball, what other sports do they, or activities, not just
sports? Good question. So next Saturday, all these wonderful short-suited men will be wearing their tuxedos. They will be escorting.
Right.
13 princesses are competing live. This is like 13th year we've been competing at this pageant. It's a big hair show. It's runway. You'd be surprised to know that we have models getting ready right now. And it's a big, big event. Ladies, if you love hair, if you love exotic stuff, if you love fashion, the girls are competing. They've been getting ready since March. Mm-hmm. And these guys are ready to escort them, so we could use you guys. The music, I already hit up all your artists on the way out.
Yes.
So I got the Instagram, they're there. Hopefully Jerry can make it. So we're doing things and we need you guys.
I'm sure they'll recognize.
Any one of you guys want to speak?
They do.
Come on now, grab that mic.
Don't be shy now.
Come on, please.
He's like, I read something. Come on, man.
All right, tell us a little something about the program. What you enjoy about it? Come on, new flex. Let me see you flex on them.
Flex.
You got it.
I enjoy basketball.
The basketball?
Yes, sir.
What position you play?
Point guard.
Point guard? How long you been playing point guard?
Well, I can play point guard and shooting guard, but I just now, like, recently just started playing point guard.
Okay, and what's your favorite subject in school?
Math?
I was going to give you a math question, but I might mess it up myself.
What's 2 plus 2?
No. Really, Diamond? I think the audience can answer that.
I don't know that one.
No. All right. And then, come on, one more. Who else want to talk? Yeah. So tell us what you like about the program.
What I like about the program mostly is, like, Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, when I come from, like, school, I do my work and I go play basketball. Like, when we're not playing basketball, like, Coach Fuchs would tell us stuff about, like, when we get older, how it is. And, like, we should, like, she said we should always have a backup plan for, like, if we mess up and, like, get injured in basketball, like, we should always turn back to our books.
Yeah. So what would you like to be when you get older?
If I don't play basketball, like in the Army or Marine.
Okay, all right. Go ahead now.
That's great that you touched on that information that she gave you, because a backup plan is super important.
Yes, I just want to add, he's a genius. When I first met him, his parents just crashed one of our programs and just locked him to me. But he's one of those guys that knows everything that's happened behind the scene of sports.
Yes.
He knows his stats. He watches the game.
Okay.
He knows everything. And I said, you know, that's just monetary stuff, you know, what we can build. So he undervalues.
Because you see with the question, I was like, what you going to be when you get older? And he was like, well, if it ain't basketball, but you got your backup plan. That's all that matters.
The backup plan is so important because, actually I was a basketball player myself. And, you know, I was pretty good. I probably could have made it into the league. I'm not saying I would have been Steph Curry. Anybody,
oh, Diamond.
But no, I mean, I really could have. I was one of the top players in my school. Look it up. I broke records.
All right. I'm going to believe you this
but
time.
Other than breaking records, I also busted my knee. I blew my knee out at the last year of high school.
Wow.
So luckily I had a backup plan.
Yes.
You know, so that's very important. Please, round of applause for that. You have to teach these kids every aspect.
How's that knee now? You talking about stinky leg and twerking over here.
You know, I could do some things.
No, get out of here.
I can't know the basketball no more, though.
But there's anything you want the audience to know and the people that's listening?
So just thank you again. We could use your support. And just to share with my guys, too, that I want to rock on that lesson because I've been doing a lot of my study in hip-hop. One of our former partners with Kevin Leggett and then Sok Abdulkadir, we had a lot of guys who connected me. Even though I was older, I didn't grow up necessarily with the connection of hip-hop. And I started studying again with Kool Herc and a lot of the guys who grew up in the Bronx. And you know, they're disconnected from that. And the pride that comes in knowing your history, not just, again, in sports. I always say that in the sports world, if LeBron and Carmelo and one other player decided to go to HBCU school and said, we're not going to Tennessee, and you mad the dollars that would be attached to our black athletes and to our people.
Yes, ma'am.
And so, you know, understanding and identifying the pride in our culture through music and through sports and how much we as a people hold the weight and the control.
Yes.
I try to encourage them because they're an asset to the community, and the community will try to use them for what they have.
Yes.
But so I do encourage you guys again, please visit the website, newflex.org. Mm-hmm. I am Coach Felix. This is New Flex. They were excited. They thought they were going to say a lot, but I knew they would get trapped.
Come on, New Flex. Real quick. Can I get everybody's name? With the mic ahead, hand it down.
My name is Jaden.
Go ahead, Jaden.
My name is Quentin.
Hey, Quentin.
My name is Malachi.
Hey, Malachi.
My name is Lewis.
Hey, Lewis.
Thank you again.
All right, can I get a big, big round of applause for our kings, our future kings in the building, and Coach Felix. Thank you so much.
Do remember, follow them on social media. Remember
yes.
To donate if you can. If you can't donate your time, donate some of your money. Because Nestor Felix is doing an incredible job with these kids. One more time for Coach
Felix. One more time. Donating your time is even more imperative in this time of the week. Support your community. Good job, guys.